Hi, I'm Ricky with CRMLS. And in this quick tutorial, I will be covering how to create your own custom results list and export it. Now, when you perform a search here in Paragon, it doesn't matter which search class you do. Just remember, each result will show up based on that class. So if I do a residential search, it will be a residential result. So by clicking on residential, I can just pull up one of my old searches here. So I performed a search and I will execute that search, which will bring me to my results grid. Now at any point, if I don't like this results grid, I can make certain modifications. So for example, when you guys come here, your action icons are actually hidden. Some of them are hidden like so. What you can do is move your mouse over that column and to the right. Once you move your mouse to the edge of that column, you will get a double arrow pointing left and right. You will then click, hold, and drag to your proper distance. Now, again, that's completely up to you. I just made sure that all of the action icons can be seen. Again, I can do that with any column. Just move my mouse over the header, move to the right end of that header, and then click, hold, and drag. If I don't like the placement of any particular column, I can click the header of that column, hold, drag, and drop it where I would like it to go. Just remember, whatever changes you make are saved. So notice it says success, saved column preferences. So they have been saved. Next time I execute a search, everything will show up the exact way I see it here. Now, if you made a mistake and you would like to change any of that, first thing I can do is just move my mouse at the very top and we have customize. I will click on fields. And here on the right are all the fields we currently have in our results. If there's any field I would like to move, I can click, hold, drag, and I can move it from here. I can also remove it. If I don't want that field in my result, I can select it and hit remove. If there is a field I would like to show, such as stories, in the top box where it says find, I'll just type in STOR. And we have stories total. So I can take that column and add it to my results. And then I can click, hold, drag, and move it where I would like it to show up. I want it right after MLS area. Now, a couple things I wouldn't change. I would not change the name. This is your system default, so it's called Property System Grid. If you made any mistakes and you would like to go back to the default, here at the bottom, you have a revert to default button. And then finally, when it comes to the actual results, here you have the result name and here's the code. So if you want to see the short label, which is the code, you will check this box. In the column, if I don't want to see listing pictures, I want to see just pics. Then I will choose short label. Okay. And then when it comes to other fields, such as status, I can choose short value. So you have two columns here. You have short label and short value. Again, short label is referring to the code here. They don't have an example of short value, but I can give you an example. For example, on status, instead of saying the word active, you will see ACT. So if I want short value, I'll select short value, hit save. And there we are. It actually shows just A. If I need to see the word, back to customize fields. And under status, I'll get rid of short value. And then we'll be back to seeing active. Next thing I would like to show you is the sorting. If you may have noticed, I have a number one next to status. That's because status is my first sort. If they all have the same status, my second sort would then be by zip code or postal code. And my third and final sort will be by price. So if you would like to change your sorting, move your mouse over customize and click sort. And here I have my first column sort, second column sort, and third column. You also can choose whether that's ascending or descending. So again, we click the dropdown, we can select whatever we want, and then choose if that's being displayed ascending or descending. Once you hit save, you're ready to move on. Next thing I would like to show is in the top right-hand corner, you have reports. You also have other spreadsheets. So under spreadsheet, everything that says MLS defined is yours to customize. So MLS defined spreadsheet 2, I can customize completely and make it my own. Once I've done that, I would give it its own name. For example, Ricky's spreadsheet. So now this report is called Ricky's spreadsheet. If I would like to export this information into an Excel spreadsheet, move your mouse over to export. You will click export to CSV. You will choose how many listings you would like to export. And then you will choose which grid you would like to export in or spreadsheet. I chose Ricky's spreadsheet. And we will simply hit export. And it's that simple. One last thing I want to show you is if you like the spreadsheet that you created and you want that to be your default, you will have to go to preferences, then system. And from your system preferences, you have result options. So again, preferences, system, and result options. From the result options, you have default search result. You will click the drop down here and you can select any spreadsheet you want. Now that completes my quick tutorial on creating your own custom results and exporting. Thank you for joining me.